redoing Team Modi and the reshuffle that's taking place. Here are the highlights.
There's so much work to be done, and it's a decision of the party. And once the party decides that you do A, you do B, you be a part of the government, do exactly like that.
So reshuffle, as young student leaders, when you think of reshuffle, what is it, or this particular one, what is it that comes to mind? It seems to be a real work of efficiency. People who haven't performed, they're being, you know, cut out, and those who have are being taken in. Isn't that the way a successful party or a government should work?
More than that, one more thing is being noticed here. Sanjeev Balyan was from UP. He went out because the elections have happened in UP, and they are creating more space to bring in the people where elections are due. So this is also like this is a malpractice which is going on since forever in the Indian mainstream politics, and this happens every time when elections are due. There's a cabinet reshuffle to please the people of a particular state so that they can feel that more people from their state are going to the cabinet.
Do you think that works? I want to ask the audience. Do you think that works?
No.
Okay, somebody who thinks it works and somebody doesn't think it works. Please take the mic. Yeah. Yeah, go ahead.
Well, I think it works because, you know, the kind of people that they are in India, the kind of mindset they have, you know what, all of them, they think that, okay, he's from my state, he's from my, you know, like, he's from my district, so I should vote for him, and that's,
so
I think it's a...
My representative has been made minister, so I'm benefiting.
Yes, yes.
Okay, somebody who thinks it doesn't. Yeah.
What about the people of other states?
That basically, yeah, when the reshuffle happens, they'll feel left out?
Yeah, they'll feel left out, obviously.
Okay.
What them?
Ma'am, Uma Bharati ji is out. Sanjeev Balyan ji is out. Pandey ji is now UP president. So, ma'am, right man at right job wala koi aisa scene nahi hai yahan pe. UP mein election hua.
Ye aap kyun keh rahe hain ki right man at right job nahi hai? Who is giving
ma'am, dekhiye na, UP mein election khatam hua to wahan ke ministers ko withdraw karke aur sangathan mein bhej diya gaya. To jo right man hamari डिफेंस मिनिस्ट्री एक
उसमें तो हमें नए मंत्री मिलेंगे
नहीं नए मंत्री अब मिलेंगे पर हम कितने कैजुअली ले रहे हैं
no one knows for sure.
हम कितने कैजुअली ले रहे हैं पिछले तीन साल से ये भी एक पॉइंट है पारिकर जी चुनाव लड़ने चल जाते हैं वो कहते हैं अगर मैं यहाँ से चुनाव हार गया तो मैं वापस से डिफेंस मिनिस्टर बन जाऊंगा तो डिफेंस के लोग कितने कैजुअली ले रहे हैं ये भी एक देखने वाली बात है
लक्ष्मी नारायण डू यू वांट टू कमेंट ऑन दिस द फैक्ट दैट डू यू थिंक द allegation that the government has taken the defense portfolio way too lightly?
I don't think the defense portfolio is being taken up responsibly by able ministers now and politicians. One more thing I would like to add here is why don't you think whatever the reshuffle is happening, it's just based on merits? Because just one example, you can see there was a railway minister when the BJP government formed the government at the center.
Right.
Then after some time, Suresh Prabhu was brought in. And look at the way Suresh Prabhu is working. He is just revolutionizing the railway system there.
He has just submitted his resignation.
There.
He's working
revolutionizing the railway. Railways, what do you mean by that? Have you noticed the number of derailments which have happened in the past few days? Is that
is
revolutionizing?
Highest in last 8 years.
Has not there been any derailments or bombings
in
railways
earlier? It is highest
in
last
8 years.
You can't blame past government
but
for everything.
Were they so frequent? Were they ever so frequent?
And we're going to bring up those numbers. Numbers also suggest, Lakshmi Narayan, I'm afraid, that the number of people who've died also in that period is higher than other ministers as well. So that claim of yours perhaps doesn't really convince. Yes.
Ma'am, main is reshuffle mein meri ek bahut badi expectation ye hai ki prime minister ji ko bhi resign kar dena chahiye demonetization ke failure pe. Unhein turant resign kar dena chahiye kyunki ye kaun batayega ki 100 log jinki death hui hai demonetization ke कारण उनका जिम्मेदार कौन है जिन किसानों ने डीमोनेटाइज
रीसेंट रिप्लाई हैड यू सीन द गवर्नमेंट सेड इन पार्लियामेंट दैट दे आरंट It can't be linked directly to demonetization, those deaths which took place.
Okay, Center for Monetary of Indian Economy has given out figures which say that more than 150,000 crores have been lost by the informal economy. So who is going to pay that money? Who is responsible for that loss? Okay. Isn't it the finance minister
Harsha
and the prime minister?
Harsha of the NSUI has said something really radical. He is saying that the prime minister himself is responsible for what's happened in demonetization. Do you think that's outrageous, or someone agrees with him?
As Suresh Prabhu is willing to resign as a railway minister, who will take the responsibilities of those who died?
I think.
Okay. Okay. And I wanted you to comment on what he has said, the NSUI has said. Yeah, what did you want to say?
Yes, we can partly, like we can directly ask Mr. Prime Minister, Prime Minister Mr. Modi to answer those questions, because he was the one who was the main mastermind behind all the decisions, because actually no one was consulted, no economists, no one who could have predicted the consequences that we have been facing right now.
I want to ask you, if they say, because that's what the BJP has said, they've given these details, the 5 points which I read out, which have benefited, including more digitization, more money. Are you not convinced by this?
No, I would say that the benefits are there. There must be some benefits. But the thing is, we don't have to just look at the benefits. We have to do a cost-benefit analysis. At what cost?
Correct.
As my friend said from this panel, that 1,50,000
crores.
15,000 crores have been lost in the informal sector, and so much money have been lost in printing the currency, and so much deaths have taken place. Obviously, there are some merits, but at what cost? And was demonetization the only way to achieve these merits?
Okay, that's what a lot of people are asking. Yeah, very quickly.
I would like to add, the paper in your hand is one of, there are ads being printed out, and Mr. Prime Minister, Mr. Finance Minister is there in those ads, and to add to the losses of demonetization.
No, on this one, the Prime Minister is there.
I'm not talking about this particular ad, but there are several ads being printed out to convince the people that demonetization, this exercise of money laundering, was a successful exercise. Who is paying for these ads? Isn't it the taxpayer?
Okay, I'll let you speak. I just want to get another question. Yeah, what did you want to say?
My question is on reshuffling of cabinet.
Okay.
Because two ministers from Bihar, Rajiv Pratap Rudi and Giriraj Singh, have resigned.
Right.
And I think this is...
Giriraj Singh thing is not confirmed just yet. Yeah, it is something that is being speculated, but it's not confirmed. Yeah, go ahead.
Okay, Rajiv Pratap Rudi. And my question is that from AVP member, is there is opportunity for Simanchal people, that someone from Simanchal will lead Simanchal people and represent in cabinet?
Do you want to take that, Lakshmi Narayan? What's interesting is, of course, the RSS is meeting in Mathura. Yeah.
See, why not? Why not? Anybody can represent, they can come from any part of the corner of the country.
Right.
Just if the person is able and he is capable, he can become he can represent India, whatever bigger portfolio he can take.
Why do you think only Himachal? Okay.
See, why do we have to? This is very weak. I mean, this is a very narrow thinking, that since we are from Himachal Pradesh, since we are from Andhra Pradesh, somebody has to become a minister from it.
Okay, yeah. Please. So I agree with you.
Yeah,
as we end, and we have just very little time now, I just wanted to ask the audience and our panelists as well, if there's one thing you want from the new team Modi, from our, the people who run our country, what is that change you want? Or is there a face? Yeah, that gentleman at the back. Yeah, go ahead.
Ma'am, at one point that is mentioned that they opened lots of accounts.
Yes, that's
but
right.
I want only one thing to add in that account. The money is not there. So when Indian government or Modi government
opened an account, but there must be money in that account.
Back. Otherwise, that account is not
worthy.
He
wants his 15 lakhs.
Okay. So, I mean, 15 lakh, ma'am.
Ma'am, I have a point.
Yeah, go ahead.
Ma'am, Pradhan Mantri ji ne mera question reshuffle aur demonetization dono ko link karta hai hamare aaj ke dono topic ko. Mm-hmm. Pradhan Mantri ji ne kaha tha 50 din mujhe de dijiye, uske baad jo saza aap mujhe dena chahenge, aap jis chaurahe pe bulayenge, hum aapko kehte hain aapko kisi chaurahe pe aane ki zarurat nahi hai, aap apne office se resign de dijiye aur ek kisi kabil aadmi ko bhajpa ke hi unhe pradhan mantri bana dijiye.
जो सिर्फ हवाबाजी के लिए सामने आके डिमोनिटाइजेशन जैसे डिसीजन ना ले, सारी चीजों को एनालाइज करके उसके बाद डिसीजंस ले।
Well, you're, NSUI, you're really asking for something which sounds totally impossible.
Lakshmi Narayan, just 50 din ki saza hai jo ye log mang rahe the.
Lakshmi Narayan, just you know, as we sign off, what would you say to them? What would you want to see from the new cabinet as a young leader?
As a young leader, only thing I expect from the new cabinet is to do their responsibilities or duties in a well way and look after the welfare of the society entirely. And one thing is, demonetization is not a failure. See, though we are not specialists in and we don't have the facts and evidence.
You are defending the indefensible.
See, that is your perception.
No, that is nation's perception, my dear brother.
Okay,
no, that's not nation's perception.
I just want to get a last
see, a few people. No,
yeah. One
few
second,
people
yeah,
sitting
ahead.
In a studio and.
Actually, I want to ask. I have witnessed the consequences of demonetization, that this labor sector of our society, who work for daily paid wages, they faced. At that time, problem and
that's
failures.
They went jobless. Basically.
Well, they went jobless, and they didn't have money to feed their family, cause at that time they work under big businessmen's.
Yes, so, I completely understand and completely agree with you, and perhaps that's a perfect note to end on. What this show with student audience, student leaders, perhaps shows is the fact that the government needs to do more to. Get their message across on this particular issue, demonetization. So many questions there, and perhaps the new team that's going to be there in the Prime Minister's Council needs to answer all these questions. That's it on the show today. We'll be back again next week. Thanks for watching. Goodbye.